big welcome to the Church of St. Michael and All Angels. And this is our tutor concert. It's part of Spink Opus Music Festival. So we're absolutely delighted to be here today. And we're delighted with our lineup of musicians. We had a super set of music workshops earlier today up in Skullmurra, and we'll be continuing those tomorrow. I'm going to say very little over the concert, because I'll say a small bit at the end just in terms of thanking people. But just a small little bit, and you'll see some notes in the program that you might have picked up. Our main ambition through this project has been primarily to inspire young musicians, and the best way to inspire young musicians is to let them see and work with experienced musicians. So our musicians we've got here are a very experienced bunch of musicians, but they're also a very inspirational bunch of musicians. So I'm going to hand you over to them. I have no idea what they're playing, but I've been told that there was a threat of lilting at one stage, right? However, we're going to open with a full group, and then musicians will introduce themselves after that as we go through the night. In the event of an emergency, which hopefully we don't have, we'll have the exit, the door you come in, the door at the back there on your left, right behind you, and then musicians have an express exit out through the sacristy at the back. Hopefully we won't need any of it. There is a toilet which is at the back through that door there at the back. And we're aiming to have about 90 minutes of music, so shortly after 9 o'clock we'll probably finish it up, okay? So, I'm going to hand you over to our musicians for the evening, and hope you enjoy it.
Thank you. voice. I am going to introduce our next musician now. So Aoife is going to give us a tune real quick. And yeah, I'll be doing a slight bit of emceeing just because I'm not doing much else other than singing two songs. So a slight bit of emceeing is this evening.
I forgot I was
earlier in
this. For the oldest person. So I don't know what I thanks for having me. It's lovely to be here. Thanks, Lawrence, and me to Lisa and everybody at Spink. It's brilliant. And we're going to play a couple of marches that come from Dingle. Well, we played from Dingle. And Deirdre and myself were lucky enough when we were growing up to be part of, I'd say we're kind of obsessed with like marching in Dingle. We have a fife and drum band, and we go out in the van, and our street, I was telling you earlier, our street band, our colours are blue and white, same as Leash, so it's great to see all the blue and white. But these, so last, was the last week of Friday? We have the earliest prayer in the country at 6 a.m, so these are two marches that we would be playing at 6 a.m. on Paddy's morning. There'd be about 40 fifers and about 10 drummers waking up. So if you can imagine that, we'll do a bit of a gentler version of the two marches to tonight. The first one is called Bold Feeling Men, and the second one is called O'Reilly's. So the two old marches I make.
They said, will you play that tonight? And I said, I will. And so I don't want to let them down, but also I'm regretting my decision to say yes right now at that. So I'm going to start with a slower, first of all, though. And there's a lovely connection, actually, here with Abbeyleix Group of Parishes with Edward Bunting, in that the organ, or one of the organs here in the Group of Parishes, came from Trinity College in 1842. It was brought down here. And so I thought it might be nice to start off with a slow air collected by Edward Bunting at the Harp Festival in 1792, 50 years before the organ arrived here. called On Spink, Sure Enough, or The Cry of the Joyce. Thank you.
I'm going to continue now with a song. This is one of the ones that I actually did with the lovely ladies in my class earlier today. It's called Carrickfergus, and it's based on a place in Antrim that I've actually never been to, but I've seen from across the water, and if it's anything as beautiful as the melody of the songs, I suppose it must be a lovely place. But yeah, so this is Carrickfergus for you guys.
I wish I was in Carrickfergus, only for nights in Ballygran. I would swim over the deepest ocean, only for nights in Ballygran. But the sea is wide, and I can't swim over, and neither have I the wings to fly. I wish I a handsome boatman to ferry me over my love and I. My childhood days bring back sad reflections of happy times spent long ago. My own dear friends and their own relations have all passed on now like melting snow. And in the days of the ceaseless roving, soft is the ground, as black as ink, with gold and silver. Oh, I would support her, but I'll sing no more now till I get a drink. For I'm drunk today, and I'm seldom sober. So come all ye young men and lay me down.
How are you? Will she come on? Yeah, that's great. Thanks. That was a beautiful one. Thank you. So I had the absolute pleasure of teaching a brilliant young piper local to here called Daniel today. And getting to meet all these young musicians is inspiring in itself. So they definitely deserve a big round of applause. And thank you. great to be here, and thanks so much to Laois and all the committee here. It's been gorgeous. It's just lovely. So thanks so much. So I'm going to play a descriptive piece of music. And there's a lot of people. There's two ladies here local to Rock Chapel, and they're great. Oh, they're down here actually at the back. And this piece of music comes from not too far away from there, in County Cork, where I'm from as well. It's a great place. So we've got to kind of to you, so. Anyway, so this piece, it's called Governments North, and it describes the battle at Cunnacunnus, which is kind of almost near the UN, is it? On the border there between Cork and Kerry and Limerick. But anyway, it describes the battle at Cunnacunnus and the death of Alistair McGillicuddy, and it happened during the 1600s, and it inspired, when we're talking about inspiring people, it inspired loads of folklore and loads of pieces of music. So this is one of them, this version is a mixture of the version that was collected by Canon Goodman during the 1800s and also inspired by a wax cylinder recording that was done of Mickey Cumber, who was a piper from County Kerry. So anyway, I'll give it a go.
Thank you.
because I'm local, they've given me an awful lot more work than anyone else here tonight. So, I don't know about the rest of you, but during lockdown, I had an awful lot of free time. So, I ended up writing a book about whistling. And one of the most interesting things that I discovered was that actually one of the most famous whistlers from all over Ireland was actually quite local to here, a woman called Winifred Vartry Rogers. And she actually performed a number of concerts here in Abbeyleix in aid of this church. I don't know what she actually may have whistled. We have no idea, there's no mention of what she whistled. But we do know that she performed quite a lot on the stage in the Gaiety Theatre and Theatre Royal and places like that. And in 1906, she performed a tune, a set dance, that was danced by Countess Markovitch. So I thought tonight, just in memory of her, we might do a tune, a set dance called Madame Bonaparte. Thank you.
portrayed them with Kerry tunes, so we were doing a few polkas, so I might play a few Kerry tunes in the same way. Muireann mentioned the Goodman collection of Canon James Goodman, who collected music in the 1800s, and Kerry mainly, and then was
exiled
to Cork, you know, like a lot of us have happened to it. And I'm going to play a slow air from that collection called Mom Even Air, and then I'll follow it with them. It's like, join in. We have a connection with the Blast Islands. Our granny would have, well, was born kind of off the islands, but would have been relatives of the Inish Ficklan, and ended up moving back to the islands to rear her nieces and nephews, and always had a good connection with there. And this slide would have been from a cousin, Dolly, who would play them. We were lucky enough to get to re-record some tunes on the reissuing of the Black CD from, that had been done kind of an archival thing. Aoife likes to talk more about it, so I should have let you introduce it. But anyway, I'll try it.
Perth Drolene,
so like the Rands, they used to play it on the island, they come into the mainland to parade around with some of these tunes, so I'll try that. Okay. Thank you.
I'd do something slow, but I've changed my mind after that, because I kind of want to keep the beat up, I guess. So for those of you who don't know, I have a background in theatre, and unfortunately for you, that means I love a bit of audience participation. So we're going to do a bit of a sing-along for this one. I can see some really happy faces right now in front of me. But it's just a little ditty, so it's nothing too complicated, but I'll teach it to you first before I start the song. Don't worry, I'm not going to throw you in the deep end. So just to start off, I'll sing a bit, and if you guys repeat after me, sound good? So it's a ring-a-ding-a-dong, a ring-a-ding-a-dong, a ring-a-ding-a-daddy-o, a ring-a-ding-a-daddy-o, a ring-a-ding-a-dong, a ring-a-ding-a-dong. Whack for the daddy-o, whack for the daddy-o. Beautiful. You'll know when it's coming. The song is called The Town of Abbeyleix. I'm not going to tell you much about it because it's kind of one of those ones that explains itself as it goes along, and I don't want to spoil anything for you. So I hope you enjoy anyway. In the town of Abbeyleix there was a lassie dwelling. I knew her very well, and her stories are the telling. Her father kept distill, and he was a good distiller. But when he had a drink, well, the devil wouldn't fill her with the ring-a-ding-a-dong. A ring-a-ding-a-daddy-o, a ring-a-ding-a-dong. Whack for the daddy-o. She had a wooden leg, just hollow down the middle. She used to tie a string on it and play it like a fiddle. She fiddled in the hall and she fiddled in the alleyway. She didn't give a damn, she had to fiddle anyway. A ring-a-ding-a-dong, a ring-a-ding-a-daddy-o, a ring-a-ding-a-dong. Whack for the daddy-o. She had courters by the score, every Tom and Dick and Harry. She courted day and night, but still she wouldn't marry, until she fell in love with the fellow with the stammer. He tried to run away while she hit him with the hammer. With the ring-a-ding-a-dong, a ring-a-ding-a-daddy-o, a ring-a-ding-a-dong. Whack for the daddy-o. She said she couldn't dance unless she had her welly on, but when she had it on, she'd dance as well as anyone. She wouldn't go to bed unless she had her shimmy on, but when she had it on, she'd go to bed with anyone. A ring-a-ding-a-dong, a ring-a-ding-a-daddy-o, a ring-a-ding-a-dong. Whack for the daddy-o. She had children up the stairs and children by the byre, another 10 or 12 just a rolling by the fire. She fed them on potatoes and soup she made for nettles, and a lumps of hairy bacon that she rolled up in the kettle. With the ring-a-ding-a-dong, a ring-a-ding-a-daddy-o, a ring-a-ding-a-dong. Whack for the daddy-o. She led a sheltered life, eating porridge and black pudding, until her husband died, and he died so very sudden. And when her husband died, she wasn't feeling sorry, so she rolled him in a bag and she threw him in the quarry. With the ring-a-ding-a-dong, a ring-a-ding-a-daddy-o, a ring-a-ding-a-dong. Whack for the daddy-o, a ring-a-ding-a-dong, a ring-a-ding-a-daddy-o, a ring-a-ding-a-dong. Whack for the daddy-o.
Thank you. beast of the bog. What's that for that, Jason?
I was born for sport, is the second one. And then the third one is Chopin Schnock, I think it's called. I was composed by an accordion player from County Mayo called Joe Carey. The first two was actually recorded by played by the Innisfree Ceilidh band, which are a Ceilidh band I grew up listening to and really was inspired by, and the one the Old Ireland band, because that was the name. So this is the one for one.
think we're worse because we're sisters for not practicing together, but anyway. These are two slides from the playing of the mighty Julia Clifford, great fiddle player from Sri Lanka, and one of the first women that came to the fore in the tradition, you know, in the mid-20th century. She's a great woman. There's lovely clips of her on YouTube. One of them, she's playing this first tune called She Can Dance and Dance, and the second one, I don't have a name for her, but we just call it Julia Clifford. Is that right?
Wrong. There's no pork has been played yet. So I was kind of going, I was toying and froing between hornpipes and jigs and reels and everything like that. Next thing, sure, they hit the set of slides. And I said, that's my mind made up, I'm going to have to play a set of pork. So, and I promised there were rock chapel women down there as well, I'd play a set of pork. So they disowned me if I didn't. So I'm going to play a set of four porkers, two of them I've been playing since I was a child. I learned them in Not Degree, actually, off the great Johnny O'Leary. My grandfather used to bring me down there for the sessions in Den O'Connell's bar. Johnny was brilliant. Anytime I went into the session, I was only a small young fella at the time, and he used to sit me down beside him and he used to say, young fella, you need to learn this one. and if I was struggling through on it, he could play it 20 times the same session until I got it. He was brilliant to pass on his music. So that's and there were the first two were actually recorded by Jackie Dale and Seamus Cray on their 1977 album, and it's a brilliant Steve Looper album. So the first one is Jim O'Keefe's, the second one is O'Keefe's. The third one, I think, is Dennis Murphy's, but as in, if you call any poetry Dennis Murphy's, you get away with it, so I don't call it Dennis Murphy's. And then for the women from Rock Chapel, I'm going to play the new Mark Poetry to finish.
Thank you.
backstage. Okay, so myself and Greta are going to do duet now. So we're going to play some reels. The first one is called.
Is it Fred Flynn's or Finn's?
Okay, so Fred Finn's, and then the next one is called Trim the Velvet, and the last one then is the Bag of Spots.
Listening to everyone that's playing has been fantastic. I am going to play a
set of hornpipes for you next, Cronin's Hornpipe and the Boys of Blue Hill. And before I play it, I just want to mention two girls that were in my class today. So they're both playing the concertina about 6 years by now. And the reason I know that is because I'm the first one that threw a concertina at them on a ferry to Wales with a diagram of the concertina and said, here, learn that. And they did, they came back on the Monday on the way home and they were both playing tunes for me. So it's great to see their musical journey progress over the years. And again, I'm going to play two more parts. Leah and Kate are the two girls who are going to get that.
Thank you.
set there, guys. So we just wanted to thank Spink once again for having us all. It's been such a lovely day so far, and we're really looking forward to tomorrow. And I'm sure what will be the highlight for everyone is the kids' concert tomorrow and everything after the workshops, and we're really looking forward to that time. And we're going to just invite Lawrence up to say a bit about that before we end.
So, thank you, Molly. Maybe you'd like to just introduce you to all the musicians one by one. So I'm going to start from the far right. I can invite you to stand up. It'd be hard, Muireann, with Deirdre and Pipes. But Deirdre, Granville and Harvey. Aoife, Granville. Thank you. Thomas Ahern. Jason McGuinness from Sligo. Greta Curtin from Curtin. For a man whose name is Finn, you seem to be having a problem difference between Finn and Finn. Alan Flynn. And Finn. Muireann Meehan. Robert Harvey. And last but not least, Molly Donnery. I really don't want to hold you very long. A really big thank you, first of all, to Canon Patrick Harvey for his generous permission for this magnificent church, this magnificent venue. And I was thinking of the quote during the concert that said to play music is to pray twice. So it's been a fabulous evening of music and prayer here. So well done to all of our musicians. And a big thank you to Canon Harvey and all the parishioners of Abbeyleix. Doing an event like this is a big event, and it's a risky event from a financial point of view, so we're very appreciative to Airgrid and the Laois Kilkenny Community Development Fund. So they've been really, really helpful, not just from a funding point of view, but for other areas as well in terms of putting the weekend together. So big thank you to Avril and Gustavo who are here from Airgrid, and the whole Airgrid team that's here that helped us. A lot of you will think that I'm the only person in Coltis in Spink, and I'm not. And in fact, I've been trying to retire from my job. And so the real bosses in Spink Coltis now are Una Aylward and Genevieve Bennett. And I said to them this evening, one of you guys should be talking, you're the boss now. And they said, fair enough, we're the boss, you're going to talk. So a big thank you to Una and Genevieve. Big thank you to... All the rest of the committee did a huge amount of work behind the scenes. Maria, Maeve, Marianne, Linda, we've got Gillian and Marguerite, they'd be the women from Rock Chapel. And risk that are missing out people. There's also a bunch of people who have helped out in terms of car parking. Chris and Mark did a lot of work around sound earlier on today. So a really big thank you to everybody, really, and if I've forgotten anybody, I really apologise for that. We thank you then to our wider community who throughout the year, whether it's a small event or a big event, are always a big help and a big support to us. And then last but not least, our own teachers. These guys are fabulous teachers to have here today. We've got our own teachers throughout the year who coach and inspire our own musicians. So we've Paula, Patricia, we've Aaron, we've Kira. And we've also got Cleona and Ava coming through. And Mark here on occasion has been known to help out on drums, and David on piano as well. So we have a fabulous network of musicians coming through, and that's taken a lot of time to build up, and we're really appreciative of particularly our older musicians having stayed connected with their younger ones. So I think that is everything for the evening. I'm going to have a really fast look here. No, I think that's everything. So I'm going to hand back. Safe home. Thank you very much. There's a small possibility that there might be a music session in a public house afterwards, and we haven't quite figured out whether it's the Leakes Bar, Leonard's, or whether it's Mooney's across the road. So if it's not in one, it'll be in the other. Okay, so we might even see some of you there. So, Molly, I'll hand back to you to sort that.
So we're going to finish up on a song now and a set of tunes and after that from the lads. The song is The Parting Glass, so of course if any of you know it, absolutely join in. We're going to have some more of the lovely singers on stage join in for that as well. And then the guys are going to finish up with some tunes, George White's Old Copper Plate and Sail on the Rock.